The following is a non-profit piece of garbage. NC Ongoing's video coverage, the gaming article, comment time, my updates, up next, what's new, Pokemon giveaway, helping hands, voting time, ask and answer, reminders, PP chat talk, Pokemon ads forums coverage, NC news, and random content of the week, all owned by Natas Commander, Christopher Jams, and the NC Dalek. Please support the official release. Okay then, so first in line we have some Pokemon Lands forum coverage. I would like to keep these at one episode featuring one thread, so one more thread this time around, and I'll probably cover some more next year because I have a lot of stuff to cover in the meantime. So let's get into the thread that we got for you today. Now a little while back I actually asked everyone on the Pokemon Lands forums, that was a pretty generic question to be perfectly honest, but nevertheless I thought, you know what, might as well get my input on some general knowledge and ask them what their favourite Pokemon game was. Now to be honest, I was actually quite impressed by the amount of people that actually responded to the thread. I expected, say, about a couple of replies, but to be honest, I actually got a lot more than I originally was expecting. So if anybody that replied to this thread is watching this, then thanks very much, I enjoyed reading your answers, and in this one I'm going to respond to them. So I pretty much have told you what you need to know, so I'm not going to bother reading the thread on what I typed. So reply number one comes from Dinaman12, and he says, "Black and white were alright. The only thing I didn't like was that there was only 5th gen Pokemon, and that got me kinda bored. Pretty much played through it the game once was enough for me. However, I have a feeling Black and White 2 are gonna be much better because the Pokemon from multiple regions are going to be included. My favourite Pokemon game was and still is Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness. I really enjoy the Shadow Pokemon series because it is a game with 3D battle scenes and better graphics than DS. Animations were much better too. Now you can say PBR is better because that has even better graphics, but PBR has a terrible single player. Please note to yourself that this is all my opinion, and the storyline in Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness was seriously one of the best. The only game that could compare is the Mystery Dungeon series. Well, that's pretty much my opinion on my favourite game." In all honesty, I completely agree with this notion. My favourite Pokemon game is actually Pokemon White 2. Right now, because chances are Pokemon White was my favourite, but since White 2 is technically the sequel to White, I'm gonna say I probably will prefer White 2 over White. But Pokemon XD was definitely one of the greatest entries ever to be included in the Pokemon franchise. I can definitely agree that this is your favourite. Now, why do I think Pokemon XD is a great choice? Mainly because Pokemon XD actually did have quite a lot of great stuff going forward. It had a not so generic storyline. In fact, the storyline was quite original for the most part. You had the great Shadow Pokemon catching, and you never knew when a Pokemon was going to show up that you could capture, which I thought was a great touch. And the storyline was pretty much original, just like Colosseum's. And it also expands Colosseum's universe a bit. Although one thing I didn't like about Pokemon XD was the fact that even though the main villain is the same as the previous game, unfortunately there wasn't really any strong connections to Colosseum. You don't really need to have played Colosseum to understand XD, because while it is true the villain is the same organization, it's pretty much the entirely new people. The entirely new crew is basically new. So same organization, just different people basically. Person that made a return that I really loved from the original was Myra B, and I really do like Myra B. He's easily one of my favourite Pokemon characters today. In fact, he could be my favourite villain out of all of them. That is if you can consider this guy to be a villain. So, gone on for a while now, this is definitely a good choice for your favourite game. The next reply comes in from Jimmy Crystal, and he says Pokemon Yellow. I know this probably sounds kind of odd coming from me, but since people name this game and talk about how nostalgic it is for them, although I didn't start playing until I was 13 or 14, I think a lot of the reason is that it was based off the anime, which is how I got into Pokemon. I also love how there are bits of the story about Pokemon that aren't legendary. As much as I love the myths surrounding the legendary Pokemon of all the generations since, after Generation 2, there weren't many story arcs about non-legendary Pokemon, like the Marowak in Pokemon Tower or the Ampharos in the Lighthouse. I guess I really love the way that Pikachu kind of grows closer to you as the game goes along, and you can't argue Pikachu's antics aren't hilarious falling in love with the Clefairy in the fan club, or falling asleep in front of Jigglypuff. I do wish they'd make it easier to play the Surfing Pikachu minigame though. My copy of Yellow, the first Pokemon game I ever got 2 years ago now I think, is still good, and I still play it on my Gameboy Advance, Rock Tunnel, Here I Come. I'd love them to do a remake though, the lack of running makes it unfortunately slow, and I'd love to have the versus Seeker. I used to have so much fun playing through Fire Red. So in a way, it kind of still feels nostalgic for me too, just a different sort. Now unfortunately, I can't say too much about Pokemon Yellow because my first Pokemon game was actually Colosseum, and then I started it from there. I was mainly third generation onwards, so as a result, I've never actually played the original Red, Blue, Yellow, Gold and Silver and Crystal. So I can't say too much about the Pikachu edition. However, I can say a couple of things because of the fact that I had a friend that owned Pokemon Yellow and I saw him play it a few times, and I have seen a couple of playthroughs on YouTube of Pokemon Yellow, and for what I've seen of it, it looks to be a pretty good game, and I can definitely agree with the nostalgia trip. Of course, because the Pokemon anime has Ash and Pikachu wandering around all over the place, it does really add to the nice touch because you do the same in the Pokemon Yellow edition. As for a remake, I would definitely entice it. If they made a remake of Pokemon Yellow, I would be well happy. And in all honesty, I'm actually really surprised that they haven't done it yet, because when you consider how often Pikachu has been featured in terms of event Pokemon, you would think that by now they would have got the full blown and decided to make a Pokemon Yellow remake. So why they haven't done it, I honestly don't know. Maybe for some crazy reason Game Freak actually think that maybe Pikachu has been overdone a bit too much in terms of events, which is why they haven't made another game. But I would still encourage it. I still would love to see a Pokemon Yellow remake. Plus, it would actually complete the original set, because they remade Red and Green in the form of Fire Red and Leaf Green. So to complete the original set, we do kind of need to have a remake of Pokemon Yellow to go alongside them. So yes, I can definitely see where you're coming from, though it's not the choice I would have. Dark UA leaves a comment saying, "My favourite Pokemon game would have to be the Pokemon board game." What? No! No, wait! Oh, just kidding. Thank goodness for that. I am so glad you just said that. Oh man. I have to say, I very much love the Pokemon Colosseum and XD Gale of Darkness games. Throwing a story into Pokemon made a game a real treat for RPG fanatics like me. And he actually links something in the next part, which, you know, you can go check out if you want, but I actually haven't seen it yet. But it actually is an article, apparently, about how things would happen if Pokemon turned on humans. Yeah, that actually sounds quite interesting, actually. I probably should check that out myself. I actually didn't notice that when I was copying and pasting this. So, yeah, there's a little plug in there. Tell you what I'll do. I'll actually put a link to that in the description. So if you want to go check it out, then you can go see it. And I've already talked about Colosseum and XD for the most part. Although I would, again, definitely agree that the storylines were definitely very unique and brought something new to the table. Anything else I've already said, pretty much. My favourite Pokemon game. That's a hard one. Oh, yes, I could do it. Ah, no, I think I better not. It's a choice between Pokemon Emerald and Pokemon Yellow. I love Pokemon Yellow for many of the reasons Jimmy mentioned. I am a fan of the anime and love to watch Team Rocket, and having them in the game was a treat for me. Also, my favourite rival story has always been Gary and Ash, so I replayed the old games and even Fire Red Leaf Green several times. I loved Emerald for the stowaway. The land layout is my favourite, and I remember the constant underwater exploration that I loved to do. Mystery Island was cool, even though I can't remember if I ever found it, lol, and played through the Battle Frontier, and battling Steven was always a blast. That's all I got right now. Well, Pokemon Emerald is one of those games that will always be hailed as one of the best, because one of the things I loved about Pokemon Emerald was in Ruby, you went against Team Magma, and in Sapphire, you went against Team Aqua. But what I loved about Emerald was it had you going against both of them. So it was quite fun to see exactly how things would turn out, because in that game, you have Rayquaza as the featured Pokemon. In addition, you have Kyogre and Groudon, which is really awesome. Not to mention the main event of the actual games actually involves all three of them. Although it was a little bit disappointment that you didn't get to capture them both right away. Well, you got to capture Kyogre and Groudon later on after you complete the game, and you can get Rayquaza at the Sky Pillar anytime you want, which was, to be fair, pretty awesome. But still, I'd have been much happier if they say made you catch Rayquaza right away. But apart from that, it was a brilliant game. A great storyline. The only other problem I really had with Pokemon Emerald was the storyline felt a little bit too close to Ruby and Sapphire. Apart from the main event, everything else was relatively the same. Yes, there was the odd differences here and there, and there was also Scott showing up, but that was pretty much it. And of course, you also had the event that took place between Magma and Aqua, which was probably the biggest change. So, all in all, it was a good story, and it's definitely one of those games that every Pokemon fan needs to own, because it's really good. So, I can understand why there's a lot of controversy going around between Emerald and Pokemon Yellow. Sorry. Anyway, that's pretty much all there is to say for the threads this time around, and I hope you enjoyed me going through these. You'll find a link to the Pokemon Lads forums and all the threads featured in this video in the description. Thank you for listening, and let's move on to the next section. Okay, so it's time for my comment time. So let's take a look at some of the comments that I got for the video coverage view count readings that I put up about a couple of weeks ago. So I actually did get some pretty interesting comments on that video, so let's see what people have to say about that. Now this comment's a bit long, so I might spend a little while here, so you've been warned. So the younger brother says, "You're normally in videos, I'm sure nobody wants to see, no offense. But if you got more popular in the future, maybe so. I'm not trying to be mean, I just watch your PBR episodes. 2. Mario Kart Wii is kind of boring to watch, and Marvel vs. Capcom, you're not speaking in it, and all I see is button mashing fighting. I do have the game, and I don't play because of that. Number 3. Maybe if you did a Pokemon walkthrough or Let's Play, or any other walkthrough or Let's Play for any popular games, or I don't know, you would get view." Well, the first problem I have with this comment is non-gaming videos? Nobody wants to see them? Hang on, Ninguno65, Blaze the Movie Fan, El Pitman Master, Alty the Dog Trainer 1. Those are 4 people right off the top of my head that I know like to watch all of my non-gameplay videos. So to say nobody wants to see them, sorry, not playing right. Yes, I will admit that my gameplay videos do get a lot more views and attention than my non-gameplay videos, which is kind of why I made that announcement about the Christopher James Switch. But despite that, I still do know people that like to watch my non-video game related stuff. So Mario Kart Wii is kind of boring. Well, I can understand that, because I don't like just watching someone's gameplay without any commentary or any sort of editing involved or any sort of gimmicks that involve editing. But I can understand if you find it boring, and I do respect that opinion because of the fact that, you know, if it's just me playing the game and you don't like watching that, then fine, that's perfectly understandable. So, yeah, if you find that fun and boring, then fair enough. Marvel vs. Capcom, well, I'm not speaking in it because technically Marvel vs. Capcom 3 was done under my mini-series format, which is like a toned-down version of my regular format, and one of the toned-down features is it doesn't offer narration as much. Granted, there was the Naruto UNS2 videos that did feature narration, but that was only because in that game you can't mute the music. Chances are, if I cannot mute the music and I put it under a miniseries, I will narrate it to give it some sort of feature. Whereas if I can mute the music, chances are I will not narrate it. It's just that I'm not allowed to monetize that because of full screen limitations and such. But if I did a proper Marvel vs. Capcom series under the regular format like this show, then I would definitely narrate it, because I feel as though it's the sort of game that does deserve to be narrated, and I will definitely narrate it if I did do that game under a proper format. And also, button mashing fighting. I'm sorry, but I cannot agree with that. If you go, I'm just going to say this. Go to Miles923 and check out his Assist Me series for Marvel vs. Capcom 3. You will find loads of combos on there that can easily be done without button mashing. Yes, it's true that there are some button mashing combos in that game, but on the other hand, it is very deep. You've got assists, you've got standing heavies, standing mediums, crouching heavies, loads of different versions of attacks to pick from. Yes, you can button mash, but if you do, chances are you're going to fall flat on your face quite easily, because a lot of players take Marvel vs. Capcom very seriously, and you can play it without button mashing at all, and quite professionally, may I add. So trust me, Marvel vs. Capcom is not a button mashing fighting game. It really isn't. If you're playing it like that, then honestly, go into training, trust me, you'll be amazed what you can actually pull off with some of the characters in that game. Yes, it's difficult, yes, it's time consuming, but yes, it is worth it. Number 3. Maybe if you do the Pokemon walkthrough or let's play. Well, Pokemon walkthroughs are overdone. I really do not like Pokemon walkthroughs in the slightest because of the fact that I believe that they are just done too much. I've pretty much known, I think every single Pokemon game has had at least 5 playthroughs across the whole of YouTube. I'm sorry, I will probably never ever do a Pokemon playthrough because I believe they are overdone. I am much more comfortable with making online videos, mainly due to the fact that online videos are a lot more mystery around them. It's hard to tell sometimes how things are going to go. I think it's a lot more fun competitively. I just favour Pokemon online on the Wi-Fi a lot more than the actual stories. Yes, the stories are interesting when you're playing through for the first time, but on the other hand, I cannot say. I just think the glory with Pokemon rests in the competitive side of things. But that is why I will probably never ever make a Pokemon playthrough. Plus, in my eyes, apart from Black and White and Black and White 2, I don't think Pokemon are very strong on story. Yes, they have good stories, but I think they're kind of outclassed in compared to the likes of Final Fantasy or even Mario for that case. But, you know, is that a reason to use against them? I don't think so, but I do still believe that you should have a decent story, and I think that's where Pokemon is kind of lacking. But that's just my opinion. You know, you are welcome to disagree if you want. But anyway, final part about this comment. Why don't you do a let's play for any games or I don't know? But that's what Gameboy 26 is for. Gameboy 26 is my playthrough channel. It's where I do my playthroughs. Granted, I don't do let's plays, so I personally don't like let's plays very much, maybe because I think they're overdone, but I personally do prefer post commentary a lot more than live commentary, because I believe it's a lot more interesting, because you can narrate one without having to worry about the actual gameplay. When you're playing a game, it can affect the narration. So anyway, I've spent quite a while on this comment, so I'm going to move on to the next one. Crusader Nova says, I know the feeling, as I have put some things up in the past which I haven't got a suitable return. Views are, but comments, suitable comments, are better. Like the PBR stuff I upload takes a bit of time, not to mention some other things I've done. Mainly I have posted videos asking what I could do for our channel, and people just don't seem to care. I'm just hoping my Christmas special this year gets a decent response, else I won't do any more. There was a few mistakes here and there, but no problem. Now, the whole people doesn't to care part, the thing I've noticed about YouTubers when it comes to posting content is they only seem to pay attention to the people that are developing content that attract a lot of attention or have great quality, professional narration and really good, you know, style of presentation and sound effects and everything. So I can understand that people like that get the attention they want, whereas people like us that don't seem to, well, we do put a bit of effort into our videos, but we just don't seem to get back that nice feedback that we wish we could have, which is very disapproving. You know, it can be very discouraging as well, because it really does make you feel like you've put a lot of time into working on a video just to have it, you know, not seen much and maybe get one or two comments. To be perfectly honest, I was actually a little bit disappointed with how the CJ and NC video I made, because the CJ and NC video I made a while back took actually quite a while to make with all the editing and all of the screen shifting and everything, which I was a bit annoyed by the fact that only one person actually commented on that video, which was Pikmin, by the way. But I'm not trying to attack people, I'm not trying to provoke comments, but I do know what you're talking about when you say that you don't get the feedback you want. Also, I definitely agree about the PBR stuff. One of the reasons why I actually stopped making PBR was because of the fact that the editing was getting way too tedious. I just lost all patience with it, to be honest, because some of the videos that I edited on PBR sometimes took over an hour. I'm not even joking. Some of them took over an hour to edit, because when you're stopping and starting, you're cutting and up and down. It just becomes really, really, you know, unappealing and very tedious. So, I agree with this comment. It definitely is true to its words. So, to avoid making the time any longer than it already is, let's move on. Blaze the Movie Fan has to say, I have no idea why people aren't interested in lesser known channels after I tell those people why I like them. But that's something you have to deal with. You have got me to subscribe to some channels because of your video coverage, but to be honest, I think you should stop. I know your goal is to get channels more popular, but it's pretty clear to me that it isn't working since I only check those channels out. Yes, I must admit, I can definitely see what you mean by that, because of the fact that, well, problem is, this is one of the reasons why I made that video talking about video coverage. In all honesty, the problem is, because my subscriber count isn't exactly really high, you know, yes, I have around 900 subscribers, but the problem is only about 1/10 of them are actually active. My videos usually range around 40 to 100 views, depending on what series it is. If it's a Pokemon series, it usually gets decent views because that is the main feature to my channel, but anything else usually ranges around 40 views or 30 views. Mario Kart Wii usually ranges around 30 views. But the issue is, that's why I asked that question about why should I continue video coverage? Because in all honesty, I just felt like the editing I was putting in to the video coverage just wasn't getting the attention it deserved, or needed, so to say. I would say deserved, but that sounds a bit, you know, big-headed, because I'm the one that makes the videos, so I'm going to be a bit biased, and I'm going to say that people should watch them. But I don't like to be completely biased and say people should watch them, and the series deserves the attention it deserves, because I let my viewers decide whether it deserves its views or not. But the fact that, again, like you clearly said, if you're the only guy that actually checks out the channels that I actually feature, then what's the point? Literally, what is the point? So I'm actually glad that you made this response, Blaze, because, you know, it really does help me come to the decision that I actually have come to. But I'm going to talk about that in a later video. So, anyway, that's actually all the comments I've got for comment time this time around. I was going to feature another video on this year's comment time, but to be honest, the length has gone over quite longer than I anticipated. So, I'll end comment time here and continue the next video in the next one. In the meantime, let's get on to the Up Next section. Hey guys, time for the Up Next section, where I'll go through what you can expect from this channel for the next month or so. Now, I'll go through a few series this time around, so here we go. First one I'll get out of the way, Pokemon of the Week. Now, I'm not going to talk too much about Pokemon of the Week this time around because of the fact that I am actually undergoing quite a lot of changes and improvements to Pokemon of the Week, but I'm not going to announce what they are in this episode because I'm actually going to put them into either an NC Ongoing Extras or maybe just a simple My Update section. But either way, Pokemon of the Week is on the hold for now, but as soon as more details get released, I will let you guys know about improvements I'm going to be making to that series. I've already had a few neat ideas from you guys and from my own mind, so should be able to make it a lot better than it was originally. Now, the second thing I want to talk about, Pokemon DS Wi-Fi. With the closing of PBR, I am now going to be focusing my Pokemon main series videos around Pokemon DS Wi-Fi. Don't worry too much about the quality and all that, because I'm still going to be applying the whole emulation quality thing. You know, once I get it working, that is. So, yeah, look forward to that. So that's the improvements being made to that. Should be out sometime soon, hopefully. Probably be moving the next couple of weeks, maybe. A couple of weeks to a month, because I'm still playing through Pokemon White 2 myself right now, so I haven't got a chance to, you know, start recording Pokemon DS Wi-Fi battles yet. But hopefully, it'll be within the next couple of weeks, or a couple of weeks to a month. But don't worry, there's going to be plenty of other stuff going up in the meantime anyway, so don't worry about that. The next we're going to talk about is Mario Kart Wii. Now, I know Mario Kart Wii has been down for quite a few weeks now. I very much apologise for that. Yeah, sorry, that was my cat. I apologise for the lack of Mario Kart Wii videos. It is quite annoying, I know, but I promise, you know, I am going to be working on that probably today, actually. On the day that I was recording this, I probably will then be going onto the Wii to get as many Mario Kart Wii stuff recorded as possible, so I'll definitely try to do that as soon as I can. And the last thing I want to talk about is NC Ongoings. I'm aiming to do two more episodes of NC Ongoings after this one, so it's going to be like three episodes in the course of December. I'm probably going to make a gaming article special that I keep saying I'm going to do, and I'll probably conclude, say, around Christmas Day or towards the end of the year. Yeah, so to give the 2012 edition a decent send-off. Now, I know NC Ongoings is just a standard show, but let's just say that I'm going to try and do something pretty special for you guys. I'm not promising anything, but let's just say that I'm going to try and plan something special for the end of this year. So, provided everything is all and I get the green light for the good to go, I should have something pretty interesting in store for you guys, so look forward to that. And that's pretty much all there is to talk about. As always, if you have any questions about any of my series that I upload, then by all means, send me a message. But otherwise, let's move on. Now before I go, I actually have a couple of things I wanted to say. I know I've already mentioned this throughout the video, but in the next episode, I'm going to be doing an Ask and Answer segment. So if you have any of those Ask and Answer questions that you would like to submit, I would really appreciate it if you did leave a couple, because I do want to get a decent amount of questions answered, and I do have some questions to answer, but there isn't really enough to make a proper segment. So if you have any questions for the Ask and Answer segment, then please, by all means, send them in. You can either leave them by comment or send them by private message. Choice is yours. Heck, you could even leave it for a channel comment, but, you know, might as well send a private message or leave a comment if you're going to do that, because since channel comments are pretty useless now. And also, if you watch the whole video, you might actually get something you might not be expecting. But in the meantime, I'll leave you with this. Random content of the week! Let's take a look at my most recent thumbnails. Jade is planning on going to Agra with a beautiful woman. I can't believe it. Nobody has enough power to do that. Oh my gosh, you've got to be kidding me. Nobody has enough power to go to Agra with a beautiful woman. My gosh, that's just priceless, that is. Random content of the week. Hey, guess what? That's what she said.